Do you know the symptoms of Pandorum?
I've seen it before.
Ever witnessed the symptoms firsthand? It's not something you can easily detect. It starts with a shiver, an itch, a slow boil.
Another episode of Saturday Night Horror. Today we'll be watching one that I feel is pretty good. Critics didn't like it too much. They never like horror movies, but this one has a cult following. Now it's what I call a deep space horror movie. All those horror movies that take place in space, whether it be on a ship, on a colony, anywhere like that. Today we'll be watching Pandorum. Now Pandorum was released in 2009, mostly filmed overseas in Germany. So kind of an interesting movie. It's basically, you know, the creatures on board the ship hunting everyone down, but there's so much more to it than that. There's so much going on in this movie. It's kind of hard to follow at times. It seems like it's a bit too much. But real quick, let's go tell you about the story of Pandorum. Basically, Earth has become severely overpopulated. Its natural resources are almost completely wiped out. So humanity has to find somewhere else to live, another planet to colonize. Well, they found another planet called Tanis, but it's 123 years away. Or it takes 123 years to get there, excuse me. So eventually Earth gets so bad that this giant ship, Elysium, where they load all these colonists on, 60,000 people, they launch that and send it on its journey and go to Tanis, 123 years. Now on this ship, they have different crews. They have first crew, second crew, third crew, all the way up to six that I know of. There may be more. And periodically, each one will take control of the ship because everyone is in hypersleep, kind of like a suspended animation because of the long journey. So every so often, a new crew will wake up, take control of the ship, and the other crew that was there will go back into the suspended animation. Well, this movie starts with two crew members waking up, one by the name of Bauer, another one by the name of Peyton, who's kind of a higher up, I guess. They wake up early, and in this movie they say when you're in deep sleep and you wake up, you experience what they call Pandorum, kind of like have memory loss, you don't remember everything that's going on, you're paranoid, hallucinating. So they're starting to experience it. They don't have it real bad, they're just, you can tell they're kind of out of it. So they don't really know everything that's going on, don't really remember. So they're starting to explore around the ship. They try to get to the bridge of the ship, and they can't get there. They keep having power problems. Come to find out their reactor is malfunctioning, so they have to go fix that. So Peyton stays and tries to get the computers on the ship working so we can get up to the bridge. Bauer goes searching for the reactor. Excuse me. He goes to the ventilation shafts and everything like that. Now, Bauer, on his way, he meets up with a lady that apparently was been away for quite a while, and she's weird, man. She's got, she thinks he's there to hurt her. She's talking crazy, like, no, you have to hide from them, and Bauer's like, hide from what? So, you know, eventually we find out that there are these creatures on the ship, these cannibalistic creatures that are, if the human is there, they will find them, hunt them down, kill them, and eat them. And that's what she was talking about. And, you know, Bauer, and he runs into these things. He meets some other members of the crews along the way that have apparently been waking up over time and have been quite awake for quite a while, just trying to survive and just hide from these creatures. There's a lot going on, man. And while they're trying to get to the reactor dealing with these cannibal mutants, Peyton is still on the computers, you know, trying to get to the bridge. He finally makes it to the bridge, and then he meets another guy, Corporal Gallo. Comes out of his suspended animation. Come to find out he's from an earlier crew, and you know, he's trying to find out what's going on, and I mean, it's just weird, man. It's like so much stuff going on. Then meanwhile, our other crew meets a guy that's been awake for years. I can't remember what his name was. He was the cook, and he's telling him this Corporate Gallo that just woke up went crazy and launched the pod, the suspended animation pods, for most of the survivors that were on board. So most of the colonists were launched into deep space because the Corporal Gallo went crazy. And, you know, like I said, it's just, you got so many things going on. You're trying to find out what's up with this dude Gallo. Why did he kill almost everyone on board? You got another guy trying to get to the reactor, get the ship functioning. You got all these other people that were alive for years. And then you got the mutant cannibals. It's like, it's so many subplots going on. It, at times, it's kind of hard to follow everything, but somehow it pulls it off, man. It all pulls it off in the end. Oh, man, I don't want to ruin it for you. I will say it has a twist ending to it. It's one of those endings that screws you with your mind, and you're like, man, that's messed up. But yeah, Pandorum, good movie. A lot of stuff going on, though. A whole lot of stuff going on. So we're going to watch that. I'm not going to be cooking anything tonight. My original plan was to make Cincinnati chili. When I went to get the ingredients out, found out some water got into the cupboard in the fridge where I was keeping the ingredients, and it ruined everything. So we're not cooking tonight. Next week, I don't know if we're cooking either, but Cincinnati chili is out, man. So we're just going to go in the living room, cut all the lights off, watch a movie. When it's over, I'll tell you what I thought about it, have my final thoughts, and that'll be it. So, yeah, man, it sucks. I was definitely looking forward to the chili, but we still get to watch a good movie anyway. So I'm going to go out in the living room, cut all the lights off, and watch Pandorum. When it's over, I'll tell you what I thought. So I'll see you later. All right, everyone. Got a ice cold ginger ale here. No chili, no meal. So it is what it is. All right. All that's left is to try out this light. Here we go. All the lights in the house are off, and we're going to watch Pandorum. Like I said, I'm a huge fan of these deep space movies, and I'm definitely looking forward to this. Yeah, I just wish I could have made that chili, though. Alright, everyone, so Pandorum is over. It's a good movie, like I said before. I enjoyed, I'm a big fan of these deep space horror movies. You know, where they take place on these derelict ships, and they're being hunted down by these alien creatures, or trying to find another planet to colonize, things like that. I love those deep space movies, so definitely enjoyed this one. Like I said at the beginning of this episode, there's a whole lot going on. There's just so many subplots, so much stuff going on. It's kind of hard to follow at times, man. It gets to the point where you just throw your hands up and you're like, come on, man. Something happened. Something get resolved. But, oh, man. Other than that, I don't really have any complaints about it. Just that there's so too. It seems like there's too much going on. So they wanted to get so much into the movie that it's just too much at times. I mean, like I said, you got the guy trying to get to the bridge, but he meets this other corporal who supposedly went crazy and killed almost everyone on board. Meanwhile, you got another guy trying to get to the reactor, but he's meeting up with these people that have been awake for years. And then you have the cannibal mutant creatures coming after him. It's just a lot going on, man. Like I said, that's the only complaint I have. Too much going on. The movie was awesome. The kills in here are particularly disgusting. Like I said, these are feral creatures, so they just rip you apart, man. For all you people who watch The Walking Dead and you hate Daryl, there's a scene where Norman Reedus gets his intestines ripped out by a whole group of these cannibal things. So if you hate Daryl Dixon on The Walking Dead, this movie is definitely for you. Spoiler alert, he does not make it. But yeah, man, there really wasn't any big character development. You find out what's really going on with Peyton, and I don't want to ruin it for you, but pretty much everything after that is just standard horror movie. Like I said, just a whole lot going on, man. So overall, I recommend it. I enjoyed it, and it's kind of hard for me to talk about it. Like I said, there's just so much going on. It's kind of hard for me to just talk about what I thought about everything, if that makes any sense. I'm kind of tongue-tied. I'm kind of stuck on this one, man. I'm already thinking about how bad this episode is going to be, because I can't really talk about this movie because there's just so much going on. I've said that about 10 times already, but words don't express how much is going on in this film. So yeah, that's Pandorum. We're going to wrap it up. We're going to end this like we always do. We're going to have some slideshow scenes from the movie. Next week, Either one of two things is going to happen. The next movie on my list for Saturday Night Horror is Chopping Mall, which is awesome. It has the best soundtrack in a horror movie I've ever heard. Pure 80s goodness. Chopping Mall. But I'm supposed to go out of town to one of my best friend's places, and we're supposed to have a Friday the 13th marathon next weekend. So I'm trying to decide if I want to do Chopping Mall next week or if I want to take the camera with me to the Friday the 13th marathon and get some footage and put that as the episode next week. I'm leaning towards the Friday the 13th marathon footage, so I won't be sitting here telling you what I think of every single movie. It'd be too much, but more than likely we're going to have footage from the marathon, so probably won't be cooking then if we're all together watching the movies. We'll probably order some takeout or something, but yeah, that's going to be next week. This week was Pandorum with a hell of a lot going on. I don't think this is one of my better episodes. Like I said, it's hard for me to talk about the movie because there's just, we're just going to end it, man. We're going to end it. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you didn't get confused. I'll see you next week, guys. Take care. Appreciate the support. Tune in next week. Footage from the Friday the 13th marathon. And I will see you next time.